Ranos here, and welcome episode of Space Engineers. In this episode, we're taking a look at the small antenna dish by Durbinburb, the textured build states by the Fool 76, and an update to the UNSC and Covenant hand weapons by Don't Follow Orders. And I may notice that their name has actually changed. Look up and down very quickly, does it? Also, the reason I'm not using the Spartan skin is because it's broken. There's a couple of mods I have in this world that it's incompatible with and keeps crashing the game, so I no longer have it active. So far, I found out that the Eat, Sleep, Drink, mod, no longer adds the sleep, food, and water. That mod is incompatible with that skin, which is kind of annoying, but oh well. But I do need to figure out which other mod that character mod is incompatible with. Doesn't seem to be anything logical. Anyway, first, the antenna dish. It's right over here. So first person. You can see, this small antenna dish is just a tiny little dish bolted onto a block. Unfortunately, its collision mesh doesn't match its physical shape. Which is a bit of a shame, but oh well, it only takes up a single block. I'm pretty sure the collision mesh can be easily updated. Now, this thing is small and cheaper to produce. You see, it only needs 30 steel plates, 30 small steel tubes, 15 construction components, 4 computers, and 20 radio communication components. You see, it is quite a bit less than this one. However, it also, you know, has a smaller range. You've got this one, which can go up to a maximum of 50,000, but this one can only go up to 25,000. Thus, it's not as much reach, but it is cheaper to build and cheaper to run. Well, it uses less electricity. And it also has a much smaller profile. Very small and easy to fit, especially if you don't really need the massive range. If 25,000 is all that you really need, then this is good to go. And it looks pretty good too. Guess you can stick it on a hinge or something. Although that look a little weird. Yeah, just a simple little thing. I do believe you can recolor this bugger. And there you go, you can. Ooh, but can you change its texture? Hey, which one do we do? Oh yeah, we always go disco when we go for red. Why are you changing? Oh, you did. Huh. Weird. I didn't get a sound for it. That's bizarre. You see? Oh wow, those squares are really tiny. So you can change the colour and texture of this thing. This is pretty interesting. So yeah, that's basically it. There's a tiny little antenna. Now, let's move on to the textured build stages. Which you can see, I have the block in all its different build stages, and it's all textured. Now unfortunately, only 8 of the textures are compatible with this mod. First, you have carbon. You can see, very hard to see really. You see the textures are all there. Around it. Then you have battered. See, that's a normal one there. Transferred to these ones. Then you got concrete. So you have the concrete and all the different ones, like you're welding concrete slabs together. Interesting concept, really. Then you got dusty. What is it? That way you can have a dusty, incomplete build. Which is could be handy depending on what you're doing. Then we also have glamour. All different ones. I have noticed that the textures are a lot smaller on the build stages than the final piece. It's kind of weird. Then you got rust. No, this is mossy. You got the moss all over the different things. Again, this is quite helpful for cosmetic reasons. That way you can have the build stages all textured and stuff. Could you always have had them coloured? I don't remember. I'm sure colour was added last. Like, the colour only applies in this stage. But did it apply in those? Anyway, and here we have rusted. You see, it's rusty on all the sides. And last of all, we have wood. You see, it looks like it's just got normal plywood used to make the different parts. I think it's pretty interesting. I'm not sure if the modder intended for that, but I think it looks pretty good for build stages of a wooden block. Yeah. Now, you don't... Well, in order to actually have this work like this, you do need to actually own the DLC. So you don't have access to the textures, you don't have access to all this. Because all the modder really did was tell the game to use the texture. So in other words, if you already have blocks down, they're in the build stages, that have a colour and texture already applied to them, they will automatically update to be like this. Which is handy. You really can't see the glamour that well with it being pink. Huh. Maybe I should choose a different colour. Or have the sun in a different location. Oh well. So anyway, how about we move on to the update to the UNSE weapons? Which we first have to go downstairs for. And here we are. The four new weapons added is the energy sword, the energy pistol, the energy rifle, and the needler. Although it's known as a guided munitions launcher. Which is an interesting way to call it. And you can only put three of them on here. The energy sword cannot be put on here because it's counted as a tool, not a weapon. Yeah, it's basically a grinder. So, you know, why not use a grinder to make a melee weapon? It's basically the same thing. Well, you can use the grinder as a melee weapon if you wanted to. Why do you change textures based on which one you have selected? Anyway, how about we go test them out? Although, these weapons have the same problems with the UNSC ones. They don't load right. And if we were to go in here to check the UNSC ones, that's all the different type of bullets it's got. So, you have to keep reloading to switch between all the different magazines or bullet quantities. I'm not sure why the modder did it like this. It just seems weird. But oh well. No worries. Anyway. First, with the needle. And these are going to be ridiculously overpowered too. Oh yeah. Forgot. The needle has the same issue as the assault rifle. You gotta keep reloading the thing over and over just have more than one freaking bullet. As you see. As you can also see, it destroys bullets really quickly. Wrong button. So, my energy pistol has 5 bullets. And I always use one at a time, and they do drop over time. You destroyed the entire thing, you bugger! You meant to just break the bugger and not destroy the entire block. Mean. Okay, that's just getting ridiculous. Here you go. Time for the energy rifle. Very high recoil, annoyingly. It does have 200 bullets per round. Oh, per clip. Stop destroying the blocks, you buggers! You see, very powerful, and it also has the problem of destroying blocks in a single hit. And that's the energy sword. And a bunk. And a bunk. You'll run right up. And... you hoard it out, too. See, you completely destroy the blocks, too. Yeah, I need to repair this place. Again, these weapons are incredibly overpowered, which is, annoying. You repair. There you go. As for making them, I don't believe it's possible just yet. So, for my... There you are. And if you go to here, you see you still can't actually make the weapons, as it is still being developed, as well as the ammo. Hopefully, the modder can sort out the overpowered properties of these weapons, eventually. Kind of weird how it's still ridiculously overpowered. Never mind. And I'll slap you here. I'll slap you there. And there. So yeah. Although the weapon's still in development, or the mod is still in development, and the weapons are still overpowered, they are pretty decent so far. Still need to solve the whole ammo issue, but oh well. I'm pretty sure that won't be too difficult once they get around to finishing them. I do wonder, what other weapons are they going to add? Because there's already rocket launchers in the vanilla game, so it would be possible for them to add in the UNSC ones, and including like the fuel launcher, and the other sorts of launchers that are in the game. It's annoying, since that's all there is to really show off. I can't really show off the updates to the character mod, because it crashes the game all the time. We'll have to wait until that's sorted, until I figure out which mod it's incompatible with. Meh. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye bye.